Okay, we're going to look at Margot Robbie today, and I did a social media post about a week and a half ago saying what I think she had done. You said do a deeper dive, something more accurate. We're doing that today. One of the things I see are Barbie packages, from plastic surgeries to Botox and fillers. The reason we look at these, this is entertainment. I don't know what she's had done, but it's good to look at because it gives us guidance. Hey, she looks great. She's looked great over the years. What maybe has she had done? But I think when people don't admit to what they're doing, then that can be precarious for the rest of us. In this case, as we'll see, I think she has had some things done. I think she's done it very well. We're all individuals. We go through our own journey. There's positives and negatives about plastic surgery, fillers, but the idea is that we want to look good over time. As we feel good on the outside, we want to look great. So let's look at this picture. Here she's 18, so about 15 years ago. I just want to point out a few things. So going forward, we know. Let's look at her under eye. You can see some fat pads below her eye. When you smile, there's fat there. There's also a muscle called the orbicularis oculi, and that can bunch up. There's a new filler now, Eye Light from Galderma. I did one of the first, or the first talk in North America on that about a month ago for that launch. And we were looking at what causes that. It bothers people. I was just in Japan. They love that over there. We're filling over there to create that. Shows you cultural differences. I want you to look at her smile here. Now she has a classic, beautiful model smile, just showing upper teeth and a wide smile. Let me remove these markings. I want to show you one thing, what we look at. There's golden ratios, which guide us, 1.61 to one. And these are ratios on the face that determine beauty. I believe in these to an extent. They're given for guidelines, but overall, we're all individuals. But if you believe in that or you want to know about that, if we look at the mid pupil and we draw a line down, that will give us the edge of the lip at rest, okay? She's not giving us a full 90 degree look, not smiling, but you get the idea. Models and actresses typically have a wider smile, a wider mouth, and that's what we're seeing here. I want you to note her teeth and the tooth color here as we move forward. Also the compactness of the face. Let's move forward and have a look what she looks like going forward. Here, 2010. Okay, now if we look, same smile, but look at the teeth. They are much more what? White. Not uncommon. Teeth whitening. Some people get veneers, they look like her teeth. You never really know, but definitely the dentition is whiter. The idea is the white of the teeth should match the white of the eyeball, some people say, but it's a youthful look, certainly. Pay attention to the eyes. You see the canthal tilt? Slightly upward. A lot of people speculate on her eyes. Canthal tilt surgery is extreme. Most people don't do it. She doesn't need it. She has a good, some people call it cat eye or upturn. Look at her brows. I can't remember who we looked at the other day. It was the same thing. One brow is higher than the other. Understand, this is normal. We're normal human beings, and we're doing toxins and Botox and fillers. We try and even things out, but it doesn't matter. But notice that going forward. I think the other thing we notice here, do you see a little of the squaring of the jaw? We'll look at that going forward. Look at the volume in the cheeks as well. A lot of volume in the cheeks. Could have had anterior cheek filler, but I do want you to notice the under eye. It does appear here, there's not as much fat under the eye. Could have had an under eye bleph. This is a very young age, but you can do that at a young age if people already have hypertrophy of that fat pad. It's very genetic, but we'll look at it going forward. Here we are, 2013, and I think this is a fairly dramatic change. Look at her smile. That would be indicative of lower face toxin. A lot of people do it to keep the mouth turning upward or the sad face. There's a muscle depressor anguli oris right here. We often treat that. The cheek volume does appear to be the same here, and I want to look at that going forward with you. And we notice the difference in the tooth color from posterior here to the front of the teeth, or the where most of the tooth show is. That's quite telling. And we do now see, because makeup plays a big role, as does Photoshop, we now see some lines beneath the eyes, but they're not as pronounced as over here. So it still could indicate under eye surgery, and I suspect she did have that done. Now, 2013 to 17, and we see some definite changes here. Same basic shape, but check out the lip volume here. Lips don't grow as we age. So subtly done filler is what it appears. Check out the lips here, particularly right at the Cupid's bow. This is a common thing injectors do to try and create more pronounced filter columns, and there's something here called a GK point. I'll show you that right here. This is your GK point, Glogau Klein point. And you can see there's filler right there. Two little balls. And it's common that injectors do that to accentuate that. The lip has three tubercles, one in the middle, one in the side. So one, two, three, as opposed to the bottom only has two. And you can see there that those little balls, that's a telltale sign of filler. So we can see that there's some experimentation with the filler. And I'll show you a picture without those right here. Check out this Cupid's bow here. You can see that these are not on this side, on your right. Those are empty, almost approximating what we call an M-shaped lip, which is a difficult one to fill. She doesn't quite have that, but you can just see there's an obvious difference in lips. It's not lipstick, liner, or tattoo. The eyes have the same tilt here, but I do believe it's quite possible she had an upper bleph, but subtle. We also see the hairs over the eyes, which is typical. If you have one brow that's different than the other, often wearing the hair down can, for certain pictures, if your people are conscious about it, they'll do that. But this does seem a little bit lower. Doing a facelift or a brow lift, of course, you can move one side higher than the other, not a problem. We'll look going forward, but if you're having that surgery done, you would even them out for sure. I definitely see a change in the cheeks here. We're starting to see, look how sharply demarcated this one is right here, 2017. It could be cheek filler, and that gives the impression of a buccal fat hollow. Understand bones change. She's a little young to have estrogen loss, bone loss, and bony changes, but this is around the time where it does start to occur. She's either had buccal fat removal, which I think is quite possible, but also cheek filler. And that combination would give this look. Obviously, the ergo trigger, the distance from the lip to the nose, is the same. Let's look at the nose. I'm going to look at it closer in a minute. But if you look, there is some nasal changes here. And I think she's had a narrowing of the nasal tip. Now, it's subtle. And I'm going to show you a bump on the nose that she's kept. And that's what people do to make it look like, well, maybe I didn't have nose surgery, because why wouldn't I have the obvious bump taken off? Let's look at that. Here you can see the dorsal hump. It looks like narrowing of that tip from the earlier pictures. I'll remove those markings so you can see, but that's a classic kind of thing to do, to leave a bump on the nose that's so obvious like that. And that can easily be fixed with filler, very easy. Just a little bit of filler and that would take care of that. And she has the classic upturned nose. This nasolabial angle that we look for, everyone wants that upturned nose. If it goes too high up, it looks a little bit like a pig nose, and you want that perfect angle, 100 degrees, 110 degrees, but she has it, and that's what people are looking for, but there does seem to be a narrowing of the tip. While we're here, looks like less hooding above the eyes. I can't see that she equals the other side with this picture, but it does look like maybe had a brow lift. There's no evidence of a facelift back here. If she did have anything done to the chin, that can all be done underneath. And I couldn't find a picture, of course. People don't put their chin up. Typically, there'd be a little submentum scar in the submental area that gives that away. And people often fall on their chin as a kid. And so often, a lot of us have scars there anyway, battle wounds that people can kind of say, well, that happened as a kid and I got a little scar there. But jawline filler would be another possibility here. So if you imagine cheek filler, and I always talk about the parallel lines of beauty, where you put the cheek filler in to equal the angle of the mandible. That's what I do. And what would you do to get such a sharp jawline? Something like Radiesse's calcium hydroxyl apatite. It's calcium. I have some in mine, and it gives the sharpest jawline you can imagine. But maybe here's some buccal fat removal. And again, we see the lips here. The vermilion border is a little crisp, and they're a little perfect, with a little more volume in the upper lip than she's had before, so a little bit of lip filler. And look at what we talked about for this lower bleph area. No fat pad noted. I'll take the markings away. So that seems to be more and more likely going forward that she's had that surgery. Here again on this picture, you can see that the nose was a little wider at one point than it is now. If we go here, 2023, we can see that brow is lifted. Now you can do that with Botox or Dysport. You put some at the lateral. This is the orbicularis oculi muscle. It pulls down like that. And if you treat here, you get a lift based on the forehead movement. So certainly this could be all Dysport. She'll be airbrushed in this picture. It'll be hard to tell, but again, you can get an idea of the teeth and the nose and the angle of the eyes, the canthal tilt. Here again in this picture, a lot of people are going to say, well, she aged a lot. And that's why people blame buccal fat removal for giving an aged look. But remember, the bony face changes to give that. So those are subtle changes. Add what you think she may have had done. Whatever it is, it's subtle, it looks good. But I don't recommend you go get the Barbie plastic surgery package. You're now gonna wanna watch this video all about dissolving fillers, and this one down here on things that might kill the fat pads in your face. Stay tuned here, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.